one whose name is a deliverer. In various books we read how our God delivers his people. We read in the book of Genesis chapter 3 where Adam and Eve, they sinned and they were hiding from God by hiding near the tree. Our God brought them out of that. He gave them new clothes and he gave them new life. Yes, our God delivers us. The greatest bondage the enemy tried to do is try to separate Adam from Eve. Adam to blame Eve. Eve to blame Satan. And nobody wants to be rooted. Everybody has been shaken. The enemy tries to shake ourselves. But the Lord is our root. The Lord is our root. Many of the times we think that something that comes from outside will help us, will make us happy. Or what we get in the world make us happy. But what we are in the Lord. God calls each one of us for a mission. God calls us a unique way of life. He knows everything of us. When we don't get the things what we desire, we become sad. We become worried. We become desperate. And we think we have lost something in God. We have lost something in life. Even we have prayed to God, nothing has happened. Because, and only because, we build our life on what we get instead of celebrating our life in God. Daddy, you know everything. Whatever you have given me life is the best for me. And I will live with you and with your power, with your glory. Some time ago, a young girl who was a non-Christian girl who was married, who came to the Lord, and she became a Christian. And then she fell in love with a boy. She was a nurse. Fell in love with a boy and she began to cry because years are passing, no children. The girl began to cry and the whole neighbors and her own brothers and sisters started to make fun of her. Look, you accepted Christ. And what has happened? We all have children. She used to try to tell them, see, I am accepted Jesus, not because what I will get out of my life, but he has become my life. He has given everything of me. And I just want to celebrate what he is to me. And he celebrates what I am to him. So my life is that who I am in the Lord. Not what God has done to me, but who am I in the Lord? I am his child. I am not the tree. I am not, okay, God has given me my husband and I will love him. Maybe I may not love like a child, but I love my husband and I love the work God has given me and I love everything. Suddenly her husband became sick, desperate. And at the end they found it's a cancer. She walked with him. She went to the hospitals. She suffered for him. She looked so lean. She became very lean. And on the process, hardly she is 35, she became a sugar patient. Taking her husband, answering to everybody. But her faith remained very firm. She said, I don't understand. Like Job in chapter 19, Verse 25, he says, why I lost my children? Why I lost my property? Why my wife went away from me? Why my own servants make fun of me? Why my own friends who came to see me, they blamed me and went away? I don't understand. But one thing I am sure, my Redeemer is living. My Redeemer is living. And one day, when I stand before him face to face, he will reveal to me, why did he allow these things? Not because that he doesn't love me. Maybe he wants me. He wants me. He wants me to love him. That is the answer Job got. And this girl lived like that suddenly. All her money, all her saving, she spent for the husband and he passed away. How the life would have been. She was broken. But God, in God's name, there has never end, only bends. Sometime we think, I did not get this, so that is the end of my life. No. No. The ways of the Lord are marvelous. Sometime with our little human mind, we don't understand. We like to see the things as we see. I did not get this, so God's joy is no more in me. I did not do this. I did not achieve this. I did not become somebody. So my life is no achievement. No. The greatest achievement is to know who I am to the Lord and to celebrate my life in him. My celebration, my joy doesn't depend on what God gives me, but what I give it to him. What I am to him. Nobody can take away who I am. I am his child. Nobody can take away the truth that I am being bought by his blood. I belong to him and he is mine. Wherever I go, I carry him with me. Nobody can stop me. No problem, no pain, no suffering can take it away. This great treasure that I have in me, that is him. Maybe God wants me to celebrate him. And the enemy wants me to forget about him.